Hi YouTube, BadEditPro here. This is the fifth and final episode of our video series, The Complete Restoration of the Realistic CTR-68 Tape Recorder by Clydesight. If you haven't seen the other parts of the series, just click on the annotation box on your screen and jump to the first episode where we explain exactly what is going on. In this episode, we'll see Clydesight's rather simple discovery on how to make the worn case of the old classic shine almost like brand new. We hope you enjoy it.
WD-40 cleans, lubricates, very, very compatible with plastic. Plastic is a petroleum product. This is a petroleum product. They like each other. Paper towels. You need two pieces of paper towel. This is your dry piece for polishing. This is your piece that you're going to spray the WD-40 on. Do not spray this on this. Spray it on your towel. Get a little bit on there. You don't need too much. And now, just rub it on the surface. It's like waxing your car. And get it on everything. Cannot harm it. I mean, don't screw it into the machine. Cannot harm it. And just rub it in to all the parts. Now go all the way around the machine. I'm not going to do this right now. I'm going to put the camera on pause, continue polishing, and I'll show you what happens. Okay, I've rubbed the stuff all over, and if you look at the towel here, see all that dirt that came up? Don't rub too hard, rub gently. Now all you do is buff it, and that's just rubbing it with a paper towel that's dry, and just rub and rub and rub. Now this machine, this went through the wringer. It's pretty much banged up. So even with the polishing, it's not going to look like it came right out of Radio Shack's store. I wouldn't put it back in the box and claim that it's brand new. But it looks a lot nicer now. See how nice that is? It's got a good shine to it. And you can keep doing that. If you see that some of the surface is coming off, because sometimes these silver cases are black underneath and they just put a silver surface on it, then stop polishing it. This ends the restoration video of the Radio Shack CTR-68 AC battery cassette recorder.
One of the things that impresses me about Clydesight's work is the fact that not only does he care about the technical operation of the machines, but he really wants them to look as close to the original as possible, and he tries to get them as spit and polished as best as he can. Some folks really just care whether it works, other folks care what it looks like. Clydesight strikes a nice balance.
One of the purposes of Clydesight restorations is to find the most interesting, visually appealing tape recorders. And for that, we look at the cases. And we have found some absolute gems on eBay and even in yard sales. So when you're restoring a tape recorder, it makes sense to pay attention to the case as well as the interior components. So spend the extra time. Polish up that case. Make it shine. Remember, if a tape recorder isn't pretty, what good is it? Thank you for watching this video series. I hope that it has helped you and given you some ideas and some inspiration and guides you towards doing some tape recorder restoration of your own. It's a very rewarding hobby.
So there you have it, the complete restoration of the Realistic CTR-68 vintage tape recorder a la Clydesight. Now, obviously, what we've edited out is the hours of voice and music testing that Clydesight painstakingly performed to put the machine through its paces. Of course, you know you have to do that. And if you want to hear how the machine performed for me when I got it back, click on the annotation at the end of the credits to jump to my video, The CTR-68 Lives Again. Clydesight and I hope three things for you. We hope you watch all of this video series. We hope that it helped you by either giving you ideas or inspired you. And we hope your next tape recorder project is as successful as ours. Thanks for watching the Realistic Sound video series.